Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss the power flow equation of a synchronous motor, that is how the power flows in a synchronous motor and what is the condition for maximum power input. So if you see the diagram of a synchronous motor, the equivalent circuit can be drawn like this. If you are taking your voltage as my reference, out of this voltage, because the current will produce because of this voltage, and that will pass through Zs at an angle of theta, and the back EMF or the EMF that is generated in your synchronous motor will lag behind your voltage by some angle delta. So that's why we can write it as E at an angle of minus delta. So why this delta comes, why it is lagging, we have already seen before. So I am not going into details now. So now I can write my value of V is equal to E plus IA ZS. Right. So I can write my value of IA. IA is equal to V minus E, because supply voltage minus terminal voltage divided by ZS. So I can write in the phasor form. So this is V at an angle of 0 minus E at an angle of minus delta. Remember, here actually we have to take the phasors. So this will be Zs at an angle of theta. So theta is the impedance angle. So this becomes V by Zs at an angle of minus theta minus E by Zs at an angle of minus theta minus delta. So this is what comes. So generally, whenever you want to calculate the complex power, we take the current conjugate. The reason why we take the current conjugate for calculating this, I have already taught in the basic electrical engineering. I am leaving the link in the iTab above. So if anyone don't have idea about the how to calculate complex power, you can refer from there. So V by Zs at an angle of theta, because magnitude will remain same, only angle will same when you angle will change when you take the conjugate. So this becomes E by Zs at an angle of theta plus delta. Getting it? So now the complex power input. So this complex power input I can write as S is equal to P plus JQ. This will be V into IA conjugate. So the real part indicates P and imaginary part indicates Q. So I can write my value of S is equal to V at an angle of 0. This should be multiplied by current. Current is V by Zs at an angle of theta minus E by Zs at an angle of theta plus delta. This is what came. So from this I can write this as, when you are multiplying, this become V square by Zs at an angle of theta minus E V by Zs at an angle of theta plus delta. This is what is obtained. So this is the complex power. So in order to represent this, this can be separated into real component and imaginary component. Real component will come by taking the cosine value, and imaginary component will come by taking the sine value. So I am just writing this. So this I can write as V square by Zs into cos theta minus EV by Zs cos theta plus delta, plus the imaginary component will be J. This will be V square by Zs into sine theta minus EV by Zs into sine of theta plus delta. This is the imaginary component. So from this I can calculate my active power. Active component will be real component. So I am taking it out, V square by Zs into cos theta minus EV by Zs into cos theta plus delta. This is what we got out. So similar is the case for imaginary. So this indicates the imaginary component, because it is not our concern now. So I am not taking it out, or let us take it out. So this will become V square by Zs into sin theta minus EV by Zs into sin theta plus delta. Remember this, this we are going to use in future in the coming classes. So if you are taking, generally the value of RA is far far less than the value of XS. So RA I can take as approximately equal to 0. So the value of Zs will be equal to XS, and the value of theta, impedance angle, will become equal to 90 degrees from the impedance triangle. So if you are substituting this in the power equation becomes, because theta is equal to 90 degrees, cos 90 degrees becomes 0. Here cos 90 plus delta, so this will convert to minus sin delta, so this will become positive. So this will become sin 90, sin 90 will become 1. So here it will become sin of 90 plus delta, so it will become cos delta. So those things we will substitute here. So P is equal to EV by XS into sin delta. So this is the value of the power we got. So similarly, the value of the reactive power will be, this Zs will become now XS. So this will become V square by XS into minus EV by XS into cos delta. This is what we obtained. Or this I can write as V by XS I can take as outside into V minus E cos delta. this is my value of Q. Okay, now P came, Q came. So now let us see what is the condition for maximum power input. So condition for maximum power input. So the power input just now we have calculated, power input is equal to, let us take the practical case only, not ideal case. Ideal case means that ZS is equal to XS. So don't take that, we will take the complete equation. So V square by ZS into cos theta minus EV by ZS into cos of theta plus delta. This is what equation we got. So this dPin, how it is changing with respect to delta? Because the input power with respect to delta, if you equate to 0, so that will give my value, that is the peak value or the maximum input value. So this, if you are taking differentiating with respect to delta, the first term we can see it is not dependent on delta. So differentiation of this becomes 0. Now second one, if you do the differentiation, this becomes EV by ZS into cos theta minus delta. So if you are doing differentiation of cos, it becomes minus sign. So this becomes sine of theta plus delta, minus becomes plus here. Getting it? So then differentiation of theta plus delta will become 1. So this will remain same. So this should be equal to 0. Or otherwise we can tell that sin theta plus delta should be equal to 0. So this I can take as, because theta cannot be equal to minus delta. That is not possible. Only option is this theta plus delta can be 0 when it is greater than 90 degrees, when it is coming as 0. So it will come as 0 at 180 degrees also. So we can tell that this theta plus delta will be equal to 180 degrees, or otherwise delta is equal to 180 degrees minus theta. So this is the condition for maximum power. Condition for maximum power. So now if you want to calculate input power, that is the maximum value of the power, so just substitute in this power equation. So the input power equation, take delta is equal to 180 minus theta, because theta cannot be changed, delta is in our hands, because delta will go on fluctuating, because when, at what power, particular value of delta, maximum input power will be there. So this I can calculate by V square by ZS into cos theta, this is not going to change, minus EV by ZS into cos of theta plus delta. Theta plus delta is equal to 180 degrees. So cos 180 degrees, cos 180 degrees becomes minus 1. So this becomes plus EV by ZS. So P input maximum is this one. I hope up to there the power flow and other things are clear to you. So next class we are going to discuss about what is the mechanical power developed and what is the condition for maximum mechanical power developed. So I hope this is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.